The Life of Jonas. Jonas, later known as Leader, is the main protagonist in The Giver and a secondary character in Messenger and Son. At the start of the series, he is selected to become the receiver of memory during the Ceremony of 12 and gains the knowledge of generations back and back. This causes him to rebel against the community and eventually escape to elsewhere with baby Gabriel, restoring their memories and emotions. He later becomes a leader of a village in Elsewhere and fathers two children with Kira. Welcome to the Amagi, and today we're going over the life of Jonas. Before we begin, we publish new content every week, so be sure to subscribe to our channel and ring the bell to get notified about our latest videos. Jonas, like every child in the community, was born from a birth mother and assigned to a mother and a father, becoming part of a family unit. He was raised to adhere to the community's strict rules and customs, which included precision of language, excessive politeness, and never lying, amongst other principles governed by the guiding concept of sameness. His parents worked in the law and justice and nurturing fields respectively. When Jonas was a 4, his parents were assigned a female named Lily. Growing up, Jonas was, like all children, under observation by the elders for eventual assignment within the community. He was a top student and usually well-behaved at school, with the exception of a few minor language-related infractions, as well as an incident where he was observed using an apple to play catch with his close friend Asher and was promptly called out on the loudspeaker for it. It was during this time that he first summoned the ability to see beyond, where the apple would change multiple times in midair. In reality, he was viewing its true color red for moments at a time. In the beginning of The Giver, Jonas described his feelings of apprehension towards his unknown assignment during his last days as an 11 within the community. He went through typical daily rituals at his dwelling, such as emotional consultation and dream telling. He was reassured by his parents and resumed his volunteer hours the next day at the House of the Old with close friends Fiona and Asher. Around this period, Jonas began to experience the stirrings, adolescent physical urges that the community discouraged by issuing mandatory pills that block depth of emotion. He is given the pills by his mother and takes them from then on. It was also during this time that his family unit began to participate in the nurturing process of a troubled new child, Gabriel, nicknamed Gabe, at his father's behest. Jonas noted that he and Gabriel both shared the same differentiating trait of pale eyes. At the Ceremony of 12, Jonas was selected rather than assigned as the next receiver of memory. This separated him from his peers due to his isolated conditions and mystery surrounding his training, although his family regarded it as a great honor. Part of his training conditions were strict rules of confidentiality, exemption from rudeness and dream-telling rituals, withdrawal of training-related medication, and being granted the ability to lie. Jonas soon began training with the current receiver in the annex behind the House of Old after school. He was given memories from past generations, both pleasant and painful. These included experiences of snow, sunshine, rainbows, and love, as well as war, famine, and death. He developed an acquired wisdom as well as a disdain for his own community, realizing that no one in his life or family truly feels real emotion. Jonas also grew closer to Gabriel, the new child with pale eyes, and comforted him at night with his own memories. He also became incredibly curious about Elsewhere and asked the receiver, now called the Giver, about life beyond. However, the Giver soon revealed a community custom, release, as a process of killing instead of letting people into Elsewhere, as Jonas previously thought. Releasing is revealed to be performed on individuals such as twins, criminal offenders, and the old. The Giver's daughter and previous receiver, Rosemary, was willfully released after she grew suicidal upon receiving painful memories of the past. Jonas was distraught, and both he and the Giver came to the realization that the community can't continue without their memories. They devise a plan where Jonas will escape to Elsewhere, given food, supplies, and strengthening memories to sustain him, and free the community from sameness by restoring their memories upon leaving. Jonas soon realized that the new child, Gabriel, which has been taken care of by his family unit, was due for release the day of the ceremony and decides to take Gabriel with him. Despite not being able to say goodbye to the Giver, who stayed in order to help the community recover after the escape, Jonas used his father's bike and limited provisions in order to flee to Elsewhere with Gabe. Throughout the journey, they faced dangers from the cold and lack of food, drinking from streams with Jonas giving most of his provisions to Gabriel. Eventually, they ventured across the forest and arrived at a place deemed to be Elsewhere, and Jonas, on the brink of starvation, managed to escape with Gabe on a sled across the border. Set roughly 3 years after the Giver, Jonas was mentioned in the book Gathering Blue. When Maddie was trying to convince Kira to move to the village, he indicated that Jonas and Gabriel made it to Elsewhere alive. He described a two-syllable boy, not even broken, the same age as her with amazing blue eyes, and speculated that Kira could marry him if she wanted to, which she denied. In the book Messenger, Jonas has grown up and become the leader of a village in Elsewhere, depicted as a place where all outcasts from previous communities gathered to create a cherishing and altruistic community. It is said in the book that a few years after he fled the community, he was sent a barrage of books from the giver that now make up his library, a sign that things had indeed changed. Directly outside the village resided a forest, a dangerous realm in which the villagers feared. A boy with pale eyes, Maddie, known as Matt, seemed to pass through the forest without incident and subsequently was appointed messenger by Jonas, now known as leader. Discord soon grew within the village as a creature called Trademaster began to appear and tempt villagers with material goods in exchange for their virtues. This transformed their compassion into discontent, and they soon pushed to close their borders to the disabled and broken in order to protect themselves, much to Jonas' dismay. Seer, Kira's father, soon sent Matt back to his own village in order to retrieve her before the borders closed. Jonas used his capacity to see beyond in order to sense the forest's dangers. As their journey reached its end, Jonas was captured by the forest's traps. Kira, who also possesses the ability to see beyond using her weaving skills, manages to forge a telepathic connection with him, who tells her to ask Matt to use his powers. Matt expands his abilities to heal not just the entire forest, but the village and its peoples as well, diminishing Trademaster's threat and restoring the villagers' humanity at the expense of his own life. Matt is known and remembered as Healer, a name given to him by Jonas as the village is restored. In the book Sun, Jonas had retired from his position as leader for the sake of his family, but was still revered by much of the village. He and Kira were happily married with two children, Annabelle and Matthew. Gabe, now 15, experienced the urge to return to his village to find his birth parents, which Jonas strongly discouraged. However, Jonas soon began to sense the presence of something with a connection to Gabe, revealed to be Gabe's birth mother, Claire, aged by Trademaster's powers. The village appeared to be content, once again a welcoming place built from those who were broken. A local museum was also described, containing artifacts relevant to the village's history, including the sled Jonas had brought Gabriel on. Jonas was soon comforted by a seemingly old Claire, who explained the shocking truth to Jonas and revealed much about Gabe's past. However, Claire's condition weakened while Gabe was reluctant to abandon his plan of escaping to his former community. Jonas and Kira attempted to explain the concept of seeing beyond, which he admitted was fading for the both of them as they aged. Jonas planned to use his power one final time in order to locate Trademaster and have Gabe defeat him using his own abilities. Jonas then left to take care of an ailing Claire and was soon tracked down by Gabe, which prompted him to explain the truth about his parentage. When Gabe was skeptical about the trade she had made, Jonas and Mentor explained to him Trademaster's true nature and the impact he had had on Claire's life. Gabe soon vowed to reverse the trade and restore his mother. Supported by Jonas, who saw beyond a final time in order to locate him, Gabe defeated Trademaster using his powers of empathy and clairvoyance to reduce him to dust. By doing so, Claire was restored to her usual health and beauty and was guided by Jonas to reunite with Gabe. Did you enjoy our video? Be sure to check out these other great videos from the Amagi, and make sure to subscribe and ring the bell to be notified about our latest videos.